Hey everyone, welcome back and happy Saturday. Okay guys, I've explained this in my other videos, but I'm sure these videos are going to drop throughout the day. I am recording this before 6 a.m. in the morning. That is why I have my glasses on. That is why I look the way that I do. So no big deal. Just kind of giving you an update. I'm also trying to keep it quiet, but I'm sure Jason can probably hear me. So wish me luck over here. Now, with that, guys, we're back to talk about the Real Housewives of New Jersey to give an update because it looks like we have tips and video footage. Look at Theo just walking around. Tips and video footage of Jackie Goldschneider and Melissa Gorga, who apparently are not getting along. And Danielle Cabral, she got all explosive and whatnot with Jennifer Aydin with drinks. She's like, okay. All right, Danielle. Maintain that full-time housewife role. We're going to get into it. Smash that like button. Show some love. Let's jump right in.
It's time for all your binge-worthy pop culture news. Welcome to Up and Adam.
All right, you guys. So I know that Jackie Goldschneider just put out her book. And in this book, she talks about how she really battled with an eating disorder and how battling with anorexia almost took her life. Well, originally, she was kind of moving to the beat that she spoke to Bravo and decided to take a step back because she couldn't maintain being a full-time housewife while also trying to recover. But then what happened also after, it's kind of like it was a contradiction. And I don't want to say anything's a contradiction, but this legitimately is a contradiction. It's like Rachel saying, oh, I can't do reality TV. But then like, well, if the price is right, then my mental health is not worth it. And that's kind of what she said on the Bethany Frankel interview, right? So for Jackie did an interview after and she's like, no, I really was hurt. And I wanted to, you know, be a full-time housewife. Those weren't her words verbatim, but that's what she said. So she wasn't demoted because she wanted to be demoted. She was demoted because Bravo demoted her because they didn't know where else to move with her storyline. And now after watching last season, the way that she goes in on Danielle Cabral, and she keeps on trying to bring up her brother, you can clearly tell that there is a motive here and that she wants her full-time housewife role back. Let's get into the Melissa Gorga of it all. And I'm going to play you guys a video. Melissa Gorga was caught in a recent video seemingly complaining about Jackie Goldschneider, her friend who was demoted to a friend of last season on The Real Housewives of New Jersey. This is from Reality Blurb. Though the star's relationship appeared to be strong, Jackie's absence from the main cast may show how the real friendship actually was. In a video shared by @BravoLover_ via @RHONJ facts on Instagram, Melissa was speaking to castmate Danielle Cabral at Envy while cameras were rolling. Melissa seems to complain about the friend of, saying, Jackie, she wants to be invited to every single party. I'm going to play that video for you guys. That way you can see it because, I think that that's only fair. Hold on. Let's take this down for a second. Here we go.
She wants to be invited to every single party.
We got our models here today. Trying.
She wants to be invited to every single party.
We got our.
We got. Okay. So then you see some of the comments where somebody said, Melissa is nobody's friend unless it benefits her. She loved when Jackie went against Teresa. She never wanted them to get along. I had to unfollow Danielle. Her thirst is crazy. She's cringy. Oh, see, that's the difference between Teresa and Melissa. Teresa doesn't want to throw you away just because you're friendly with everyone. Example is Dolores, but Melissa can't stand the fact that Jackie now has an alliance with Teresa and she wants to ice Teresa out. It's giving mean girls. Okay. So let's get back into this one. Ay. What do you do with these ladies? In a past interview with People Magazine, Jackie hinted at why she stepped down to her friend role. And again, it's BS. But when Bravo approached me about casting for season 13, I obviously was very excited to be a part of the show again because I loved the show. But my recovery was not in the place that I expected it to be. It was moving very slowly. I was still triggered by stress and I still needed a lot of intense therapy. After she voiced these concerns to the network, Bravo offered her a chance to be a friend of. She said they were supportive. And even though that was a really tough pill to swallow, and it was hard for me to step back a little bit after having such a big part on the show for so many years, I really knew that that was probably the best solution. It was a really tough to do. But I'm really proud of myself for prioritizing myself. I'm so incredibly healthy now, and I don't know that that would be the case if I didn't do this. So I have no regrets. Okay. I mean, that's great that she... Listen, the fact that she feels healthy is amazing. I'm just saying it does come off like... You give yourself away when you do one interview and you're like, you know, I wanted to step back and I wanted to do this for myself and my mental health and my physical health, my emotional health. And that all sounds great, right? But then when you do another interview and you're like, no, I was really affected. I was really hurt by this. That's when you're kind of losing the people who are watching because they're like, wait a minute. So were you lying then? Or are you lying now? It always reminds me of what Emily D. Baker said when she used to be a prosecutor. And when people would contradict themselves, she would be like, so are you lying then? Or are you lying now? And I think that's such a great question. Which one is it, then or now? Are you lying then? Or are you lying now? It's a great question. It's a great question. But there's more. So Danielle Cabral, who is our newbie, and we know that she... is going to be heavily featured this season. But at Bravo Housewives shared this. Danielle Cabral reportedly threw a drink at Jennifer Aydin after an explosive brawl. Danielle Cabral and Jennifer Aydin reportedly got into an explosive fight while filming hashtag RHONJ season 14. Now, do I believe this? Yeah. I'm going to explain why I believe it. I think last year, Danielle kept walking away in moments that everything, like it was like when the going got tough, Danielle Cabral got going. And I think that she kept explaining to everybody, like, I don't want to show that other side of me. I'm not being like, I'm not afraid to have the conflict. I don't want to scratch your face off. And I think that she got a lot of shit for that, which if you think about it, she's really doing the right thing. But at the end of the day, fans don't know that other side of her. So fans are just looking at her like she cannot handle conflict. And I think after going through an entire season and being for the first time watching yourself back, I've done so many interviews with Bravo talent and they always say to me the same thing. It's like watching yourself back, it completely puts things in perspective for you. It changes your perspective on things. It makes you look at it like, oh, this is how I was. This is how I don't want to be moving forward. I'm guaranteeing you that even if you guys are watching Real Housewives of Orange County, Jennifer Pedranti this season, after watching herself back and being so relaxed and taken a beating after beating after beating with Tamra Judge, she is going to come in next year with a hard-on being like, oh, you're going to talk about my family? You want to throw napkins in my face? How about this? Bah! And it's going to be a totally different Jennifer Pedranti because she's going to take in, you can't help but do it. You listen to people's feedback. You listen to their criticism. You listen to what they have to say and you listen to them rip you apart. It's just a natural thing where you're going to react. And I think that that's exactly what Danielle Cabral is doing. And Jennifer Aydin also looks for a good moment. I wouldn't be surprised if Jennifer didn't try to push her buttons a little bit. But guys, I want to know what you think about all of this. I don't want to just give this to you and not ask your opinions. Again, I know it's early over here. And when this drops, it probably won't be early. My dog's over here trying to eat. My little naked cat's running around. And Jason's asleep. So I have to get ready to go. I love you guys. And we'll see you next time. Bye, guys.